In 1973, the U.S. Supreme Court legalized abortion nationwide. The decision is called Roe versus Wade, and those who defend it are known as robots. This is how they think.
Don't call us pro-abortion. Nobody is pro-abortion. We are pro-choice.
Isn't it strange that all these people who support legalized abortion start foaming at the mouth anytime you refer to them as pro-abortion? Think about it. People who support the death penalty don't mind being called pro-death penalty. People who support government-funded childcare don't get outraged when they're called pro-childcare. People who support the Second Amendment don't become unhinged if someone calls them pro-gun. The list goes on and on. And the point is that among the world's social political movements, the abortion lobby is the only one that tries so desperately not to be associated with the very behavior they fight to keep legal. Obviously, even they know that what they are trying to defend is, in fact, indefensible. When these people start hollering about choice, we need to remember that everything people do is a choice. Robbing banks, driving drunk, stealing someone's identity, molesting children, wife beating, all of those things are choices. So obviously, if someone is going to be truly pro-choice, they would be arguing that people should have the legal right to do those things and anything else they want to do. After all, if the right to choose outweighs every other consideration, then choosing to rape somebody is as legitimate a choice as choosing what color socks to wear. But the only choice the so-called pro-choice crowd gets all worked up about is abortion. Of course, the most important thing to understand is that for the people most affected by abortion, there is absolutely no difference between pro-choice and pro-abortion. For the unborn, both terms mean they are going to have their legs torn off, their arms ripped from the sockets, their chest crushed, and their skulls split open. And once that's over, their corpses will either be ground up in garbage disposal and sent down the sewer system, or tossed into dumpsters and eaten by rats. Of course, some of their bodies will be chopped up and sold for parts. The point is, the abortion lobby knows that it is not possible to defend abortion. So they try to keep the focus on choice so they don't have to defend it. In practical terms, these people cooked up the term pro-choice to keep the public from looking at what's being chosen. Pro-choice is a marketing slogan. That's all it's ever been, and that's all it will ever be.